Well, hey, how's it going, Forum? Great to have your company once again. I made this phone call just recently in response to Mr. Roger Hayes being arrested, tried, and imprisoned in a secret court. Now, this is happening in the United Kingdom right now, even though, guess what? This guy has never been charged. He's never been in front of a court. All of this has taken place secretly. Now, what is his crime? Well, Mr. Roger Hayes refuses to take part in the illegal invasion and occupation of the different countries under the guise of fighting terrorism. In fact, he doesn't wish to support the official terrorism that's being done by these governments, which is being done by NATO, by the UK, Canada, Australia, and the United States. They don't want this guy to be a stumbling block to their plans, and that's exactly what he is. By refusing to pay his taxes, he's showing that he's not giving any material support for terrorism, and that basically means not funding the illegal wars and the illegal invasions that's being done by these corporations and these governments. So, with my support for Mr. Roger Hayes, with this in mind, I gave the Merseyside Police a quick call to ask them, how can they do this? How can they lock up someone? How can they arrest someone based on such a spurious charge? Well, guess what? This is turning into 1984, and we need to be aware. This is happening everywhere. Have a listen as I call the Merseyside Police.
Good evening, Merseyside Police. Switchboard, Rebecca speaking. Could I help you?
Yes, a very good afternoon, hey. Ma'am. Yes, a very good afternoon. How are you going?
I'm fine, thank you. You're speaking to the police. Can I help you?
Fantastic. I was wondering if you have a supervisor on duty there, ma'am?
What was it in regards to, sorry?
It's in regards to the arrest and secret trial and secret imprisonment of a guy called Roger Hayes.
Okay.
Thank you. That'd be great if you put me through.
I can't transfer you to the supervisor. Would you want to make a complaint about this?
Why can't you put me through to your supervisor, ma'am?
Well, it'll be the inspector who'd need to call you back if you wasn't happy about it. There's nothing that the police have released regarding this at this stage.
Well, are you aware of what he's been charged with?
I'm not personally. I just know that I've taken a couple of calls about this evening.
And you've got no idea what it's about?
Sorry? No, I haven't. No.
Seriously?
There's nothing I can comment on about it at this stage.
I'm not asking you to comment, ma'am. I'm calling up from the United States of America. I'm just wondering if you have a clue why he's been arrested.
I don't know anything, no. Not at this stage. I'm not a police officer. I wasn't there. I wasn't arrested. I didn't arrest him.
So slow down, please. Why are you answering the phone saying that you're the police and you just admitted then you're not a police officer? That's called deception.
No, it's not. I'm a civilian police staff. We're police staff here. We're call handlers, not police officers. I didn't answer the call as a police officer. I haven't deceived you. I answered the call as a switchboard operator.
Well, let me
I haven't deceived you in any way, shape, or form.
Let me put this to you. If you're a civilian and you're working for the police force there and people are being arrested from the civilians and you've got no clue why or how, don't you find there's a conflict of interest that your kind is being targeted?
No.
No? Why is that? Because they pay you enough to shut your mouth?
No, I don't know any information to pass. We haven't been given any information about this arrest.
So that makes it okay. As long as they don't inform you, then you have no opinion. Is that right? Ma'am?
Do you wish to make a complaint about the arrest?
I wish to make a complaint about people who accept money for doing jobs that they've got no clue about. They've got no idea what they're doing. They're in fact, you're helping the fascist rise of 1984, and you don't even know why. You don't even care, as long as you get your wage at the end of the week. Well, guess what? In Nuremberg, 1945, they had a lot of people standing up saying, well, I was just doing my job. I didn't do anything. Oh, gee, nothing to do with me. Guess what? It is something to do with you, and when you work for the Crown, when you accept money from the police force, you ever wonder why they call them a force, by the way? Because they force their will on other people, and they're forcing their will on this man, and you're supporting that by even working for that corporation. I feel shame upon you, man.
Well, that's
shame.
Your opinion, isn't
Absolute
it?
Shame. It's not just my opinion. It is many millions of people around the world are sick of the rise of the...
opinion like I am. So I work here because I've got my reasons for working here.
You work there because you've got no... You work there because you've got no other skills.
I'm not trying to impose my opinions on you as to why I work here.
Yeah, you work there because you've got no other skills except answering a telephone, and I feel sad for that.
Well, that's your opinion. I feel sad for that as well. But that's your opinion. I know my skills. You don't. the first time I've spoken to you in 2 minutes, okay?
Well, listen to me, ma'am, before you start interjecting, because my mother and father taught me good manners. I don't know about yours, but for a start...
Excuse me.
When you support the kind of actions that's happening right now, you're supporting the government going out and invading other countries. That's called terrorism. And you, by proxy, are supporting that terrorism, even by answering phones for the police force. Do you realize that, ma'am?
That's your opinion again, isn't it?
No, it's actually a legal precedent. It's been set in 1945. You are supporting that kind of terrorism. It's not my opinion. You keep saying it's my opinion. Well, it's not. It's actually a legal precedent. So I hope you're aware of what you're doing will have ramifications in the future. Do you want your children to grow up in 1984, ma'am? Do you? Would you like to...
Shall we get back to the reason that you've called today?
The reason why... That's exactly what...
Shall we get back to the reason that you've called
today? Well, hold on.
Put here to abuse me.
Put your banana down.
I'm not going to tolerate that.
Put your banana down.
I've got my opinions as to why I wear here. You've got your opinions as to why I wear here. If we get back to the point that you called, which was about this gentleman being arrested, I'll get back to the original question I asked you. If you're unhappy about it, would you like to make a complaint?
I'll tell you what. As soon as you stop flapping your gums, maybe I can get a word in edgeways, and I can tell you why I'm calling. Because people like yourself are supporting the support columns for 1984. If you want your children to grow up in misery and grow up in fascism, then keep doing your job, lady. You're doing a damn good job for 30 pieces of silver. Like a good program monkey, you're getting your bananas at the end of the week. That's why I'm calling up. Because too many people are copping out saying, well, I'm just doing my job. Just doing my job. Well, why don't you go and get a job at McDonald's? Because that would better suit your skills.
No, thank you. No. Okay, I'll clear the line down now because you're not wanting to make a complaint and you're being abusive towards me.
I'm not being abusive. These are the facts. These are the facts, ma'am.
If you find
the facts abusive, listen, if you find the facts abusive, that's your problem. Because they're not. The facts are that's what's happening to UK right now. And if you're gonna sit there and support that, wow, then we know whose side you're on, don't we? We really do.
That's my opinion. That's my choice. It's not your choice, is it?
You choose?
It's not your choice to impose the reasons that I'm sitting here on me. I know the reasons that I wear here for MerseySide Police.
Yeah, that's your choice. Good for you.
Your opinion. Do you have anything else to add?
That was your choice. Good for you. It was a Nazi's choice to join in and help them in 1945 as well. And that didn't turn out very well, did it? So if you support fascism, man, good on you. At least we know which armband you're wearing, don't we?
All right. Good night.
Do you really feel that intimidated? Well, you know, many people will say, I didn't actually achieve much. All I did was harass a telephone operator. But you know, this is exactly what needs to be done. This is exactly what needs to be done. We need to be the spanner in the cog of the machine. Now, she's only one small part of the support columns of the illegal occupations that are happening in Iraq, Afghanistan, Libya, and they're pushing for the rest of the countries on the PNAC agenda, including Syria and Iran. God help us if that happens. Now, if we be the spanner in the cog of the machine, we can bring this machine to a grinding halt. And how can we do that? By making phone calls, by speaking up, by not accepting their authority, by telling them what you're doing is illegal and I want no part in it. And while ever we do that, we are showing them that we are not sheeple anymore. We have grown up, mommy and daddy. We don't need your purse strings. We don't need to hold your hand. Sorry. But the human race has found its time to stand up and get off its knees. God bless, take care, and hopefully you too will do something like call these numbers and let them know what they're doing is illegal. It's bringing about 1984. It is bringing about a police state, and here is where it starts to stop. God bless, take care, and ciao for now.